Penn State team with its sights set not just on Big Ten glory takes the field against the Indiana Hoosiers in the conference opener at Beaver Stadium in State College. And welcome to Happy Valley again, Dave Barnett, along with Bill Curry. The fact that Penn State is 4-0, ranked second, surprises nobody. How they got here may surprise everybody.
When these 96,000 people begin to reverberate back and forth across this stadium with "We are Penn State," that means something. Among other things, it means a crunching ground attack and eating up yards and time of possession. It means no fumbles. And here we have a Penn State team that does not run the ball particularly well, a Penn State team that has fumbled 15 times in four games. It's a puzzlement. I mean, it's hard to understand.
When you put it that way, how have they put together 4-0?
I thought you'd never ask. It's with leadership, senior leadership. Kevin Thompson and Brandon Short, the two captains of this football team, have done a great job. This team has become virtually self-governing. I've never seen a great football team that wasn't self-governing. The second thing they've done is to make big plays at opportune times. 27 times this year they've had plays of over 20 yards. Shafi Fields himself has had 10 of those plays. It seems like Mr. Fields has taken it upon himself to make this offense Y2K compliant.
On the end, Indiana has won the toss and elected to defer. Penn State ready to receive the kick from Andy Payne. And deep, Larry Johnson. And alongside him, Kenny Watson, who is a speedster who has had trouble controlling kicks. Two fumbles each of the last two games for Watson. This one hangs up high and bounces over Johnson. Retreats almost to his goal line and will be crushed at the 5-yard line.
Penn State offense with Eric McCoo, their leading rusher, with only 149 yards in four games. That's 37 per game. Thompson and Harris in the backfield.
Receiving crew featuring again Eddie Drummond. Corey Jones misses another game with a hamstring. They hope to have him back in a couple of weeks. Fields, the hero from Miami, with the winning touchdown a week ago. And up front, Greg Ransom, 16 knockdown blocks. That is a target that they shoot for. It's almost an in-team competition. Ransom led the O-lineman in the deep leader blocks 1 week ago. Eric McCoo tries the right side, reverses field for maybe a yard. Long count on third and eight, and from his end zone, Thompson in trouble and sacked. Where will they mark progress? No indication of the safety. I think
got Pat Pigeon as far back in the end zone as he can, and a low end-over-end kick to Darren Graham.
Dangerous return man for the Hoosiers sets them up at the amazingly good field position for first possession of the day, and Randel-El ready to throw, overthrows Jerry Dorsey, who broke Miller, Royals, and Robine. First option of the day, and the pitch for Levron Williams. Jason Wallace. Option, a big worry for the Penn State defense, featuring great play so far from both Brown and Kropakis, who have combined for 11 sacks. Fleischauer and Wallace also up front. All three linebackers are on the Butkus watch list. You know about Arrington, Short the captain, Morrison, according to Paterno, the most complete player they have on their defense. And a huge day last week. Derek Fox forces two fumbles, gets an interception, and bats away a pass in the end zone at Miami. Macklin, Boyd, and King in the secondary. Here's third and six for Randel-El from the shotgun. Overthrown, intended for Darren Graham for an early Hoosier lead. Plenty of leg and good.
Capable of doing.
Play action for Thompson, and all day over the middle, and a crowd tried to force that one to Fields. This year, though, and again, McCoo out of the backfield as a receiver. It's picked up. Thompson decides to run, and nowhere near. Percy Gaddis in motion. Give in the eye, and Levron Williams stuffed for no gear. With Indiana pinned back, option pitch, Levron Williams across the 25-yard line, and an unranked opponent, much less of a perceived threat, at least, in Miami. Intercepted, Ascari Adams all the way inside the 10, still going. Touchdown!
7 yards out.
Turns around the feeling of the Indiana team. Just look at where this ball is going. Now, there's no relationship between this semi-open receiver, knew I could say that, and where the ball went. He threw the ball directly into Adams' hands. Good blocking. Good job by Brandon Short down there escorting his man and cheering for him. The captain is happy about the touchdown. And the whole feeling on the Indiana squad will have changed because
of
help.
Option to the other side this time. Williams cut down behind the line of scrimmage on the ankle hit by Anthony King. Steering right across the line at him. Randel-El with a quick kick. And gets a good Indiana roll down to the 23 of Penn State. That's the second quick kick we have seen this year, and I don't know if it's been maybe two decades. 50-yarder. Penn State back to work. Aaron Harris plowing, powering through the middle. With McCoo in motion, he takes the quick screen and tries to turn it through a sea of white jerseys. He does pick up the first down.
Trying to confuse the defense, and you'll see him as a pass receiver.
Looking a little bit deeper, the tight end, Tony Stewart, to midfield. 14 yards, another first. First hand through, R.J. Luke. And now Penn State, like Kentucky. Thompson, wide open as Fields. Makes a move on Hanley, up the side, and at the 5-yard line is first and...
Shafi says it's all about confidence this year. He said people can't gang up and take me out of a game anymore the way they have in the past.
27 yards, first and goal. Thompson from the 5. Heels in motion, first man.
Right now.
Luke across in motion. McCoo stepped up, dropped it at the 6-yard line, recovered by Indiana. Randel-El has him out in the eye. Still down by only 4, and Randel-El is buried for uncharacteristic of Penn State as you can get. Another loss. Jeremy Johnson hit at the 3.
Just for Courtney, number 86 here, to jump inside and make a tackle for a loss. That's his 51st of the year as he moves up on the charts, leading Penn State's all-time records in those important areas. Big man's an All-American.
6 sacks already this year. 3rd and 13. He can shoot. And a low snap, which ate him up last week. He handles this one beautifully. And a low spiral handled by Bruce Branch hit immediately. R.J. Luke at fullback. Ceramelli has been ill this week. McCoo tried to break free from Justin's team per game. He would qualify for the national rankings. On the roll, looks up, a lot of room. And Rashard tucks it away for a pickup to the 30. Critical fumble, maybe on a bad call at Miami last week. Nowhere to go on the play. Luke and Larry Johnson in the backfield. More time this time for Casey, but again, will tuck and run. Makes a move on Schaefer, dragged down in the open.
They never
field.
Got a chance to play Nebraska head-to-head to decide the title that year. This year they would.
Over the middle. Stewart, the tight end, complete inside the 10. They'll mark him at the 6, first and goal.
This is a tough throw right down the seam. Big tight end, Tony Stewart, at 18 yards, gets his head around. The middle linebacker, Schaefer's got to run with him better than that. The ball has to be lofted.
Motion from Sam Crenshaw. Give up the middle. McCoo tried to fight his way. 2nd and goal. It is Aaron Harris. Touchdown. And on 1st down. Penn State, by contrast, 6 yards per 1st down. Here's a gain and a nice one straight through the gut for Jim. Randel-El, late pitch. And handled all the way up to the 37. First man through, big yardage again for Jeremy Johnson, rambling to the 41. Drive off to a good start, right when Indiana needed to
to get something going. Randel-El tripped up as he tried to reverse his field, and we're going to have each of the last two games was squared off with the opposing punter. Trying to set a different standard now. Randel-El spilled hard as he tries to get the option turned up. James,
third and two.
Late pitch behind Williams makes a great catch. Had to stop, turn, hit. Randel-El stumbles, keeps his footing. There's the late pitch. And at the better. Johnson stretching. Did he get in? No.
That's audible.
Randel-El keeps high, steps into the end zone. Easy touchdown. Indiana right back in the thick of it.
7 yards you're talking about.
7 total yards today. 4 passing, 3 rushing. But the Hoosiers received the second half kickoff 8 yards deep. Darren Graham, they'll start from their 20. And let's check in with Dave Ryan.
Well, guys, bad news for Indiana to start things offensively. Their starting left tackle, Pete Alisara, is out with a sprained ankle. High right sprained ankle and probably will not play in the game for the rest of the way. Also, Craig Osika, their tight end, will not play. Their offensive line coach, Marty Fine, told me a moment ago it's just going to be rookie freshman tight ends going for Indiana in the second half. Coach Cam Cameron, though, very pleased with the first half. He said this first drive crucial for his team's emotional success.
He wanted to play youngsters, but not necessarily at those two spots. Not for Elisara and Osika, but no real choice now. He's a senior. He wants to squeeze every last drop that he can. Randel-El squeezes through the right side. Chased down by Bao Ju at midfield. Hoosiers on the move. Randel-El cut down by Justin Kirk. The other way, and again hit for a loss. And did Lavar Arrington had it nailed?
Counterpart as the two 11s meet up, really for the first time today that I've noticed. There may have been another time, but
two straight losses. So on 3rd and 14, screen is set up for Levron Williams. Cut down.
He was perfect out here in practice, and it did pay off.
Lots more snap to that effort by Frost. Branch from the 10. Look out. Bruce Branch will go 90 yards. Problems hanging on to the ball. Bruce Branch untouched 90 yards. The second return touchdown today by the Lions. That's the margin.
25 yards. Separates the returner from the coverage. That's too much. A missed tackle there. A very questionable play right here. Is this a clip right here by Michael Haynes, 81 for Penn State? I think so. The officials aren't perfect, and they missed one there. A big, costly mistake.
Randel-El drops back, overthrows it. 3rd and 5. Under pressure, wide open, and the catch is made at midfield. Big gainer.
Just over a yard.
Look to the pitch. Looks instead to keep. And that's a good decision. He gets hot collared from behind. 20 hits on those 37 snaps. And here's one that he didn't count on. A direct snap it to him, and his pooch kick is outstanding. They're going to run it out at the 3-yard line.
Okay.
Got 2 from their 5 from his end zone as Thompson incomplete, intended for Eddie Drummond. It feels 2 catches, and that is it for their wide receivers. Aaron Harris is spun down. Pigeon is about 6 yards deep, and a little contact by Gaddis, no flag. Fair catch, marked by Graham. Still loose at the 30. Penn State recovers.
Son, I guess it hit him right in the head.
Casey at quarterback. Thompson got just that series. Now Casey making it up as he goes, and look at him go. Another reversal. Now a foot race to the corner. And Casey with a dive will be marked out at the goal line. One official signals touchdown. The other stopped at the 3. It is touchdown.
Touchdown, 31 yards. Imagine here.
And maybe then some. He's all over the field. Look at this. What a player. This is where head coach's hair get gray. You're yelling at him, don't. And the next moment you're saying, great.
I don't know if he gets to return these 40 kicks, though, as deep as they had been. And this also into the end zone. Going to try it from 3 yards back. Lions are ready for him at the 20. Still plenty of time to get back in this, but they need to convert the third. Randel-El does. With ease. Look long, settle short. And third and five. Randel-El will keep, break a couple of tackles. Knocked down by Arrington. Now a little bit deeper, and a nice catch made by Gaddis. Spirits up. He took the loss like Randel-El pretty hard 1 week ago. Randel-El now going deep, and he has Jerry Dorsey for a touchdown. At last, he looks up, has a wide Randel-El. So 31-17, Casey back in quarterback. And athletic nose tackle, third and three. Corner blitz is picked up, dump over the middle is caught by McCoo. And Eric with a first. 7 of 9, 86 yards. Back on target and the strike at the 44. Two return scores the margin of their lead right here. McCoo into the second down.
Tackles coming in.
Motion from Fields. On a roll, Casey got it off. Another open tight end. John Gilmore is inside the Casey almost intercepted here. Fields. Third and 11. Open McCoo inside the five. Touchdown. Made it on his own. Ran flat over Greg. Should be returnable for Graham and from a yard back. Can't bust one so far today. James Boyd had him after some of the new faces. Randel-El had to pitch that one left-handed to Williams. Nowhere for left. Final seconds, third quarter. Randel-El after deciding in the third quarter. We begin the fourth with Randel-El on third and long, throwing it long and caught at the 45-yard line. This one deep for Graham and couldn't bring it in. On the ground with a delay, did not fool Kirkakis. Not many, if any, departing Beaver Stadium yet. Indiana taking over from there. 40 almost picked off by James. Three wideouts. Indiana, for the most part, staying away from three wides today. Randel-El for about eight to the 48. But it has been a banner start for this league. Williams ridden out, but more help than he got in the first half. First down for Jeremy Johnson.
Jeremy Johnson.
Randel-El, play action, now chased. Throws off balance. What a strike, though, to Gaddis, who couldn't keep his footing. Again, showed option, drops back, going deep for Gaddis in the end zone, and he caught it. Touchdown, Versi Gaddis.
Not quite.
Casey going to work to Tony Stewart. And seven for Stewart. Gilmore also four catches for 43 yards.
I thought
defensive
name. They zapped a few.
Casey. Scrambled all day and really haven't solved him yet.
Oh, man.
Oh, what a move.
Oh, gee.
On Jocelyn Dickens. Casey. McCoo over the middle. Stumbled. Kept it going.
He's not necessarily on a deep ball.
So he's getting some fourth quarter activity here. Casey again steps up and finds the open man at the 25.
Since defensive captain Brandon Short, the defensive leader, says Larry runs with bad intentions. He's looking up, people. Stewart's had a big day.
Omar Easy's first carry.
Holding on the offense. 10-yard penalty.
So it wipes out the big gain for Easy. Casey pulls up, and another grab by John Gilmore, the backup.
The receivers hook up or get to the corner of the end zone to give him a spot to throw that he knows in advance will be there.
Casey, fake right. Still can't draw a bead on him. Throws as he's backing up, and he hits Sam Crenshaw. Was he in bounds? Touchdown. Ear of Casey.
Artistry is a wonderful word, David. It really is. Athletic ability, yes. Poise, yes. But absolute brilliance in the arc of the ball and where it goes and who is able to catch.
Thompson hadn't been bad at all today. He is the captain, but Casey has made the uncoachable plays. Gray under the Wayne Hogan is the fullback. And here's Carter.
Gee, that's almost impossible to do.
Just so. This that's is beautiful. The first two touchdown game of Casey's career. There's a strike to Graham. Randel-El will step it up out of the shotgun, and the fantasy who led the Big Ten was fifth in the nation. Brady was over 200. You understand that sort of thing, which we don't want to go. Randel-El steps up, hit as he delivers. Even if it's a catch, it's not enough.
Guys, looks like it worked pretty well.
Yeah, did not get bogged down in all the celebrations from last week. Larry Johnson in a foot race. One man had an angle, and Michael Hanley, the freshman from
Oregon. You can see it. You can see it in the way they win.
Johnson breaks a couple of low tackles. Still going, and just is dragged out. Johnson, another try in the middle. Nothing doing that time for old. Let time run out on their fifth win of the year. Close for a while, close at the half, in fact. They led only 17-10, but Paterno and the Lions break it open. Behind a career day from Rashard Casey, and they won it 45-24.
You see Rashard coming across the field. He's got to have a sense of satisfaction. He has now joined that elite group on this football team who can call themselves leaders. He's performed well enough that he can be respected by his teammates, and he can grab a face mask or two if he is so inclined. And I know the coaches hope he'll step up in that area.
Again, our final, number two, Penn State, 45-24 over Indiana, which falls to 1-3.